the influence of Eastern mysticism, as interpreted by Western minds, some modern Wiccans view the gods as aspects of our higher selves, our own divine nature dwelling at the core of our being. In either case, our relationship with what we perceive as deity is just that, a relationship. It carries with it some responsibilities and some degree of accountability, just as any relationship does. The debate here is when, and to whom, do such things pertain? In the study of divinity as expressed within physical nature, the ancients chose animals reflecting corresponding aspects of divine expression. An object or living creature was chosen because in some concrete fashion it displayed to the human mind something of its own character that reflected a spiritual principle in a physical manner. Therefore, the traditional sacred animals of gods and goddesses, and the prescribed magical plants and stones of occultism, have all been passed down through generations as examples of the generative and germinative powers of divinity as expressed within nature. Within the ancient mystery traditions, priests and priestesses dressed themselves in animal disguises, wearing masks and the fur or feather coverings of various animals in order to symbolize divine principles and natures. They did this also in an attempt to align themselves with the spiritual current flowing through the creatures it animated. To become the animal was to become the principle, and to become the principle was also to become its source. This is a very important aspect of magical reasoning. Out of such magical thought among ancient secret societies arose the concept of such mythological creatures as the centaur, satyr, harpy, and unicorn. Enough remains from ancient sources concerning the ancient mystery traditions in the Aegean and Mediterranean regions, Old Europe, to have preserved many of the ancient mystery teachings. Ancient Egypt, a Mediterranean nation, preserved the Old Way concepts in the images of their gods. Many early Egyptian deities are portrayed with various bird heads. Among Neolithic religious icons discovered in Old Europe, we find that carvings of bird deities preceded humanoid deities and most other animal forms as well. The Greeks and Romans also possessed very advanced mystery cults such as the Bucinian tradition and the cult of Dionysus. In the mythology of Northern Europe, we find many of the same mystery themes. In Teutonic lands we see Odin, who gained enlightenment by hanging from a tree, and his ravens, along with Loki and the wolf. In Celtic lands we find Epona and the horse, Cernunnos depicted with a stag, and Blodgwed with her owl. In the tale of Taliesin, many bird and animal forms appear as symbols of the powers of divine transformation. The goddess in this story ends up swallowing the god who has transformed himself into a sow. The seed impregnates the gods and she gives birth to a renowned bard known as Taliesin. A study of this mythical legend reveals the inner mechanics of divine transformation as it moves through the physical dimension, planting the sow that can become enlightenment within human consciousness, these of spirit born in the womb.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.